needs coffee. We're now ready to brew it, Rob. Brother Rob and I.
Let's get a sample. Wow!
Wow, that's right. Woo! While I grind the beans and brew this, I happen to have a clip when Lee sent us the last pound of this. I'll run it for you now.
It gives you a warning on the back of the clip, on the back of the bag.
It does? Well, I was ready to run the
warning.
Clip.
Warning.
World's strongest coffee. Now I'll run the clip.
The day of reckoning is upon us! My brothers, what is life, if not to die a glorious death? Fear not, for tonight we drink in the halls of Valhalla! Roar! Awaken and welcome death!
Death Wish Coffee, fiercely caffeinated.
So Frank, what'd you think?
I think the Death Wish people are going to be calling their lawyers, suing you for butchering the commercial.
It was all in good fun. I'll tell you what, let's bring that coffee back and see what the boys think of
it. I'm sure they'll love it.
What do you think? That's pretty effective. Now, are you going to have the same reaction?
Wow.
And you have a great day. What's under there? Oh gosh. Oh, you creep. You know who we didn't check?
Kurt?
Wallace. Kurt's not here. What do you think of your coffee? Want to give it a sip? That's the wrong side. Go ahead, give it a sample. What's your opinion?
It's exploding with flavor.
He's so enthusiastic. Let's see if it's really as good as they say. Excuse me.
Death Wish Coffee, fiercely caffeinated.
Yes. What do you think?
Let's give it a shot.
Okay, here we go. Did you like that sound effect?
Wow, that is...
I couldn't resist.
It'll make your teeth turn black.
You know, if we stuck a spoon in there, it would melt.
Wow. That is strong.
It's strong. Yeah. This will make, the container says it'll make your heart stop fast. Let's tell the boys.
Hey, let me check my beats per minute.
The Death Wish coffee is ready. Come on up.
I'm gonna put something in this. This is like, wow. My eyes are tearing.
Shall we move on? Thank you, Jason. Look, we have some guests, and they're here courtesy of the Bargain Basement 10 video. Patrick has come with Dad to pick up tournament table, Atari's tournament table. And at the time, you know what they said the game was? They said it was, I'm going to put a title up, the game of the future. But now it's going to be in your house. Come back, we'll show you. Watch this beautiful game. There's Jason, you probably see him in the videos. Steven, I'm sure you see a lot of him. And unfortunately, you probably see a lot of this man, Wallace.
He's the legend.
Oh, Wallace, are you still the legend?
That's what the hat says.
Yes, but that's the hat. That's the hat. I'm the legend. How come I didn't get the hat?
Because you were all out of You're the Idiot hats.
Oh, yeah, it was a beast night. We had the idiot. Idiot.
Yeah, they sell out quick.
They went quick.
Oh yeah, they're the first to go.
I think you'll have a lot of fun with this. I guess it goes through all the different games, and then you push this, and you step through whatever you're gonna play. And now it still has an interlock switch on it, so you have to bypass that or put a switch on it. So you pick out the game you want to play. I'm not sure which ones are four player. Soccer 2. I wonder if that would be four player. Yes, I think it is. Yeah, there's one. There's two. There's three, and there's four. Here, grab one. Go over and grab one. Dad, you grab one too. You grab that one. And Pat, you'll work for two. So I was surprised. The fellow we got this from when he traded it in, he said he had this game in his... I never even heard of this thing. And he said, we play it with my family. I said, do all the controls work? He said, yeah. I said, you're kidding. So I was very surprised. But I thought, wow, what a neat concept. Because with all these different games, you can play by yourself, one-player games, or you can play two-player or four-player. So it's one of the few four-player games out there, other than the new stuff.
That's nice. Perfect.
Yeah, perfect game. Think of the fun you're going
to
have.
Yeah, pass it off to the wife as a coffee table.
No, yeah, that's a good... Yeah. That's a good idea. Do you have any games now?
I do.
Pac-Man or...?
No, I've got Asteroids,
okay.
Space Invaders.
By the way, we call that Asteroids.
That's the way mine is. It's not operational.
Oh. You should write a letter to Atari. Or call them. Like,
call the 800.
Remember when I called the... people don't like that. As soon as I do the dial, the old-fashioned dial call, I get an immediate thumbs down. Ah! Somebody just gave me another thumbs down. Now, what other treasures are you thinking of buying?
That WrestleMania.
Shall we show them? It's in the back corner. The main event.
Main event.
As we pass through here, we have them in the back corner. And here it is. The main event. The game you've been dreaming of. We're having nightmares, right, Pat?
Yeah.
Nightmares.
Ever since I saw the video.
It's neat. Now, we actually sold this. This goes back to our black and white logo days. So, I'm going to say we sold this to somebody in their private... It's been a private home for at least 20 years.
And you've already come out to get it in the house.
Yes, this can come off. You can actually unclamp this whole joystick. Now, oddly enough, somebody converted this main event to a Neo Geo. Same control panel, and they put a whole nother game in.
Okay. See the bargain you missed? I think I have another one there in the warehouse, so if you really want one of these, you could buy another one.
Well, John and Pat, you only got one game in there, so you got to come back on Saturday to pick up the main event.
We'll be back on Saturday.
Back on Saturday. And guess what? He says he might want Jambo Safari.
Definitely a racing game or some driving game.
Fun. Yeah.
So.
Well, there it is. Atari football. It's ready to go. And now I can say my classic line. Now, get out! I want to spend this money. I'm going to go to the casino.
I'd leave now.
See you Saturday, guys.
All right, thank you.
Todd, why do you have two coffee cups?
Well, I couldn't find the one, so I poured another. So
you keep putting them down everywhere. I'm sure there's more throughout the place.
Coffee. A go-go. Oh, wait a minute. Jonathan, I can use that thing from Star Trek.
Come.
Okay. We want to show you Mark's from Canada. His beautiful Wizard of War. Another one. Remember that other beauty? Well, this one's nicer than that. Because we've decked it out with brand new, this old game, Wizard of War artwork that Mark will peel off. This is the original color, which had the spatters in it. So we just touched it up. See the spatters? You know, remember when we had this in the store, somebody says, "Ew," he says, "it looks like somebody didn't paint this well. It's all covered with spatter." And I said, "No, no, that's the factory."
Clunk.
The Discotron T-molding. I need to explain that. Discotron had this bright blue T-molding. That was the only game I think did. There might have been a couple other Bally Midway games, maybe two others, but they were obscure. And when T-molding.com started making it, we found it's great color. Great color. So we have been putting it on all the games. Well, a lot of them.
Not all of the games. Not all of the games.
Now, out of all the cabinets on planet Earth, not counting cabarets, out of all the full-size cabinets on the whole planet, this is the best one. Absolute best one. And this is why. It is the smallest, most compact cabinet I've ever seen for a full size. Look at this. It's compact, like me. Okay, number two. It's got access down below. And there's speaking of access, look at
that. You made it.
Instead of access, point the camera back to the end.
All right. The door here lowers, and the circuit boards slide out on the drawer. So you don't have to open the back up. But we did. To get to the back, I'm not going to open the drawer because you've all seen Wizard of War before. But look, it's so nice back here. That's everything works in the drawer.
And works in a drawer TV design for ease of service.
Slides out. There's the new power supply. The old connector's still here for the old power supply, but why would you use that? That's junk. And the new power supply gives our board cage nice clean voltages. That's what you want. The amplifier has new caps in it, as well as the wonderful 4600 chassis. Now, I think you all know that this is probably the second best chassis in the world. Best chassis in the world is Wells Garner 4900. Second is the 4600. And the third is the 7000. That's the order. And then all the other monitors step in after that. Probably the Sanyo is number four. Electrohome's number five. 4600s, these things will run forever. The only one I've ever run into where the flyback rarely ever goes. Everything was, it was just a hefty monitor. The downside is, whatever tubes they used, the gun on the tube, it would short. So, our biggest problem with the 4600s, we have tons of the chassis that run fine. We don't have the tubes. Because the tubes took a dump. Or the burn-in, right? Oh, I gotta tell you something. On Monday and Tuesday this week, it's Thursday now, we film out of order. We had two different big groups of school children in. I've been doing this for years and I realized I never documented it. Every year we have children, usually advanced placement. Sometimes they're special ed. In this case, these kids were advanced, very high level thinking kids. And they went on a field trip to TNT Amusements. And we offer this great deal for the children where for $5 a head, in this case, they can come in and they get to see the arcade, and I give them a free comprehensive tour of back at TNT in smaller groups, of course. I think we had groups of 10 to 12 kids at a time. And we show them the insides of all these machines, how we rebuild them. We show them pinball machines inside. As a matter of fact, I happen to have some pictures. Yes. Here we are now looking at a creature from the Black Lagoon. I showed them how the hologram worked on the inside. They really loved it. They had lots of questions. And here they are looking at a shuffle alley that happened to still have a mouse nest in it. Mousie was living in this shuffle alley.
Mickey.
They were very impressed with that. So we showed them before and after. So they were quite impressed. It was really good. It's nice, isn't it? So we get a chance to show them how pinball machines work. I take them around the showroom. I show them those things. And while they're eating their $5 pizzas, $5 for a whole pie, so I think they had 10 of them, I talk to them about film, classic cartoons I ran, describe them. It was really nice. We had a good conversation. Then I showed them the circuit boards and how the power supplies supply the voltages to the pinball machine boards and what the pinball machine board. And they had a lot of questions. So. Aren't I great, Jonathan?
You take great pills.
Thank you. And look, all signed for my mark. Whose signature is that? What the heck is that, Jonathan? Look at this.
Scribble Scrabble.
What is that?
Where's the rest of the boys' autographs?
They refused.
Where are they at?
Mark, do you like your game? You're supposed to say yes. All right, look. I never saw one of these before. Now, Steel Gunner came out in 1991. The original Steel Gunner was in the same cabinet, and that came out in 1990 from the Namco Corporation. The people that made Pac-Man. They have their guns here. These guns use pots, potentiometers, to figure out where they're pointed to. The number one problem with this game is that all the wires break off the pots.
Nope.
So we made sure they were all attached. This is a bargain basement video, and the fan just started. Well, we're not stopping, because he's got to get creative. Did you see Bargain Basement number 10? We've been selling a lot of the games. Well, there's the link. And we'll have a link at the end of the video, too. Did I put a link up for something else already? No, no. But anyway, are you
Scott
ready to
here.
Box this up?
I was here first.
Scott, is it? Oh, it is on free play. Here, come back here, Jonathan. Can we see the board?
Oh. Tight as a drum.
Who locked this up?
I think there's a key in the door.
What? Now, bargain basement means they get it as it is. So the television looks good. Oh, my back. Well, the good news is we already put a new power supply in it. So the other one must have taken a dump. So this man lucks out, brand new power supply. So his logic board looks like a double stack board system, gets quality voltage. Jonathan, wheels to make it move easy.
Still weighs a ton.
I went on a delivery last night with Jonathan.
that
imbecile.
That guy left me.
He left. So Jonathan and I delivered last night. And Alley Cats. It was beautiful. We didn't even film it. We'd have no time.
That on video.
Didn't I do a great job?
Scott's
did
replacement.
So great a job. The guy gave us a $50 tip. $50.
I like it. I can deliver some valleys and I'll edit for you.
$50, bright eyes. And guess what I did with the $50? Did
you
I
spend it on pizza?
No. I said, Jonathan, you can have all of the $50, but I want a large unsweetened iced tea. And cost Jonathan at McDonald's $1.06. It's only $1 at McDonald's. But what do you think of that?
I have to go home. I gotta do something with my kid.
My fish has swimming lessons.
My fish.
What was last night's excuse?
I have to do basketball.
It's Wednesday.
Wallace, what's your excuse?
Bye.
Can't
talk to the guy.
You know, Jonathan, listen, I already ran them the Death Wish Coffee footage that we shot before.
And
they loved it. Troubles. All right, look. Remember, we had that league champ in.
But we never ever get in.
We never had one. I never played one. I never had one. And then two of them we got two in trade. So we sold this. We never had one before. And boom, two more came in. So here's number one. We're getting that ready for the showroom. What are the chances of that? We have parts ordered for this Tomcat. And creature from the Black Lagoon. This is...
Is that Mark, maybe?
No, no, we have another one from Mark. Again. All right, let's play this.
Got that heat turned off.
Look. This has, by the way, a great stereo track. Come in closer, and it'll mask out the fan. Look at the house. Here's a picture of, he's now a full-fledged Philly cop. Here's my Chris, I'm very proud of that boy. Now Ryan is a cop, he's a detective now. Detective Ryan, and then cop Jason. Look at that. What is it? They work here at TNT, and then they go into law enforcement. Maybe they want to destroy crooked people like me.
What about these bubble hockeys?
Well,
they keep getting them in.
Everybody wanted them, and now they don't.
Oh.
So I'm probably going to do a bargain basement on this for $10. Wrong.
What?
We have to go next door and do a bargain. I got to show you the games that are going out. So, Jonathan, put your coat on. Let's go next door. Jonathan, it snowed last night. Can I do it? Can I do my song?
Better not.
Oh, please, let me do it.
No. Nope.
I'm going to do it anyway. Let the storm rage on. Oh!
Got him.
The cold never bothered me anyway.
Great slam.
Great slam.
It's crated. Where's the almost super hang on?
Crated.
What?
You talk too long.
No!
Right there. Wrap and read.
I was gonna play it. Well, they saw it in the video. Is this another bargain basement? We should do more of these. We sold a lot of them.
Hmm.
Well, anyway, let's get back to and show you Secret Service. Yeah. And Fireball Classic. Who's whistling? Okay. Party Animal is going back out again. We sold this once, I guess a while ago, and came back in trade. What's a beauty. Ow, that's hot. Anyway, this is going out. All LED'd. So it is looking beautiful. Isn't it, gentlemen? And look, Secret Service in digital stereo. Now we have really prettied this thing up. And we have super brights everywhere. Here on this side is the green theme, and over here too. And this machine, it's Jonathan, where's the back glass? It's hurting my eyes. Now, this is the machine you saw. I left this on here because we're going to clean this up, and in a second, this is going to be gone. We sold this brand new. even brand new, we were putting our stickers on it. That's our black and white sticker from back in like 1989-1990. We had a bunch of these. I'm gonna say we had maybe six or seven of them brand new in the box. I think brand new, we had a closeout on them. I think they were $2,000. But anyway, we got it traded back in, I guess 5 or 6 years later, and then we put our color sticker on top of that. We were so crude, we didn't even peel off the old one, did we? Scott, you gonna plug this in, baby? Didn't even plug in. What? These boys are angry with me. John, okay, wait a minute. No, before you put that on, look. We sold, this is one of our bargain basement videos, a TECMO Knight. We had actually put a new power supply in it. Look, the boys left a quarter, a lucky quarter on top. Boys, my lucky quarter. anyway, TECMO Knight is an as-is special. If somebody wanted it, we would have shopped it, made it look like new. How did this play, boys?
Never played it.
Never played it. Okay, let's give it a whirl. Because this is going out with the Space Firebird. He's buying this as is, and Space Firebird, it's off right now. I wanted people to see how wonderful the game was. Put credits on it. I have no volume. Good, that's better. Sometimes you have to do things a certain way. It's actually got pretty good bass. Am I playing it? Jonathan, come over here and make sure this is playing. Giving a very good example of gameplay. We have to. I know we don't have time. Anyway, for $200 or $400, it's a good deal, I guess. But it does work. Anyway, let's go back here. We were discussing this. So we're going to take this off. As a matter of fact, we're going to take it off right now. Now watch. Watch carefully. Pretty clever. And guess what? Kurt's filming now.
Yes.
Because it's about an hour later.
Nice.
All right, look. Mm-hmm. Look. Isn't it gorgeous?
Agent 001.
It's like Redis new. Redis skin.
Volume.
Yes. Perfect ramp. Perfect everything, Kurt. It doesn't get nicer than this, Curdy.
It is nice. It
just doesn't get nicer. And it's just perfect. So this is going out tomorrow, Kurt. The boys are actually delivering this with that party animal. Don't you like how that comes out instantly? Watch. Hits the switch. Hey, look at that Insta switch.
Target three different songs. Did you mention that?
Yes, there are. I think we did before.
So,
there we are.
There you
go. Well, that's what my wife says when I get thrown out of the house. Anyway. Yes, it is. Look. Mark sent us this beautiful fire. Oh, no. Mark is the one. Okay, let me get this straightened out. Mark bought the Star Trek from us. That's the one with the Spock ears, remember? I'll put that link at the end. And he bought it for the family. He says, would you sell me the Fireball Classic? And as a project, we want to work on the cabinet art.
ourselves.
You're in test mode. All the electronics. Right, you know where you're in test
mode? Am I in test mode?
You're in high score.
That was the high score to date. I put the 550 and I was in test mode. You're right. So I told him, no problem. We'll get electronically, we'll get this game perfect in every possible way, which is what we did. All the boards have been done. And his family is going to do the cabinet work. Still has the original card stapled here. We serviced all the boards, including a new EEPROM up here that we burned. Driver boards heated, soundboard, and power supply. And there's Frank's button battery. Yeah, that's all we're showing. Wait a minute, Kurt, did you know that there was a theme song for this game?
Did not know that.
Yes. Hey, you want to hear it?
No.
If you well, do, how about if I sing it?
Don't do that.
Fireball, a fireball. Every time I gazed into your starry eyes.
Actually, it's a great song. That's from Fireball XL5, a 1962 marionette cartoon. They're the people that did Thunderbirds. Look it up on YouTube. It's a great, great theme song. And it's not the theme to this. No. It's all coincidental. Anyway, the cabinet work, once again, they are going to do. So the family's going to take care of all the cabinet work. Mechanically, it's beautiful. The play field's gorgeous. It has the factory Mylar still on it. We did put all the LEDs in it, but he's going to have to do some cosmetic stuff. Obviously, he's going to have to do some cleanup on this. But I think it'll come along pretty nice. What do you think? And Mark also sent us... There are the fireballs.
My heart is still a fireball.
I had to do that again.
Otherwise, we're going to have to do this.
Oh, what...
Godfather you. Remember every time the oranges were in the scene? There was another death. Don't ever do that again.
You brought the oranges in here just to upset my viewers.
I'm gonna play Godfather music right there.
I want to, I'm not going to play that music, I'm going to do this.
Every time.
Okay.
That's post-production, I don't know what you did, I don't want to know. I won't watch it, when I do watch it, there'll be this.
Ah, no, not another thumbs down.
All right, you done here, did you play it?
Oh, no, I didn't.
What's this here?
Oh, I'm sending him this.
Yes.
He said he's going to... I said, I'm not putting it on the game because it's not finished. You guys got to finish it, and then you can put it on.
Nice.
I did not write install three balls. What does that say? One boop ball or one loop ball also? Yeah, there's the loop ball. We'll take that out. So it gets four balls. All right, this is the credit button. And that loads the program.
Can you get the skill shot? No.
Oh, I forgot the skill shot. I forgot this has a skill shot. Turn the volume up a little.
I don't think the background sounds are in there, either.
There it is. There it is. Had to go up louder. I want you to listen to the deep thumping bass. If you go into either hole, you instantly lock the ball. Okay, if you go into this hole. Now to release it, you hit this. Now listen to the bass. When I had Carter. I pushed that in too far. Okay, there we go. Now this here, there's your on kicker. And this is your off. On, off, on, off.
G-I.
Do you think he's saying G-I? G-I. Now look, if you had the ball stuck here, this will release it. Did he just burp?
Did he burp?
Let's see if this one burps. No, and it came back, so it has your flip-o-matic spot shot here.
You can get three ball multi-ball at some point.
Light, I think, on the skill shot.
Yeah, oh yeah. Now we're gonna shoot. Now, you want to lob it through this one. So if you go up, and it happens to go up here, and then go like this. Whoa, see, Kurt, look.
Very cool.
Cool.
Cool, daddy-o.
However, I think they go off when you go there. Now this one lights the bumpers. That one flashes them. So you have to light them first, then you flash them. Now they're worth 3,000 points. Not bad, huh, Kurt?
Is that it?
It's 12 o'clock.
It is rather late, isn't it?
Yep. Enjoy your game, whoever's getting this.
Mark, are you going to enjoy it with the kids? Better. Better. No, I think he's going to have fun with this. Frank, are you ready to go out? We're going to go out for soup, right?
Yeah, I'm going to get some
soup. Kurt, are you going to come?
Yep.
He says that. Wait a minute, Kurt. I just thought of a way to end. You know how we can end?
How are we going to end this? Fireball.